Hi, I'm Mark Tewart, and I'm going to go over this management tip of the day. For all of you, do you do a save-a-deal meeting? Now, this is nothing new, but so many dealerships don't do it, or they'll say, Mark, we're a smaller dealership. Us managers, we communicate quite often during the day. We know what's going on with every deal. And here's my response to you, baloney. I don't believe it. It's not true. Nobody's that good. You got to formalize what you're doing every single day when you come in. You grab the managers, your F&I manager, you sit down, you go over yesterday's traffic. Did you make the deal or not? With the made deals, where are they? Are they in F&I? Are they in the back office already? Are they approved? Are they turned down in financing? If they're turned down, why? And you don't stop there. If somebody says it was turned down for this reason, you reinvestigate every single piece of that deal. The trade value, the objection that came up during the sale that landed them on this particular car. Can we look at a different car? Can we add more money to the deal? Can we look at a different lender? I don't care what it is. What can we do that will get this deal going to the right spot versus being denied? If you had a deal conditioned, why and how can we put this together and who's responsible? If you have a heat sheet, or did you have a deal returned from the bank? Was it missing stips, a signature, etc.? Who's going to be responsible for fixing this deal now? And when you walk out, which manager will have to come back in the next day with an answer on that deal? So you're going over all your made deals, the deals you didn't make, your heat sheet. I would look at your 1-3-5 rule. In other words, when you have a deal and your contract's in transit, how many of those deals are sitting in F&I? They've got one day to get in and out of F&I, 3 days from day to sell to get in and out of F&I, out of the back office, 5 days from day to sell to get out of both and be funded. Now today, sometimes you can get automatic funding. But what I want to look at is a 1-3-5 rule, and you're pushing contracts in transit because you need cash flow. I can't stress enough that every business on earth, especially a car dealership, runs on cash flow. Smart dealers turn their money. They get higher yield, higher return on investment, and they get the money rolling faster. Whether it's trade-ins, whatever it may be, the money rolls and rolls faster. So I want to look at the made deals, the unsold deals. I want to look at where it's at. I want to look at a heat sheet, contract in transit. And I want to look at any deal that's in there even longer than from yesterday. What is the total deal sitting there and why? Where are our trade that we're doing with dealer trades that we're doing with other dealers? Who's responsible? Do we have it coming and why? See, this doesn't take long, but I promise you, when you put that sense of urgency, the check and balance on the F&I person, the sales manager, the general sales manager, the office, and when you do this, nothing falls through the cracks. And a sense of urgency will increase any dealership, any business on earth will increase your sales by as much as 20%, just like that. But it's got to have a strong sense of urgency. That will come from doing a save-a-deal. Start doing it religiously every single day. I'm Mark Tewart. Check out our website at tewart.com. You can get the first chapter of my book, How to Be a Sales Superstar, for free right at that website. Or you can call us at 888-2-TEWART. And once again, I'm Mark Tewart, and here's to you and good selling.